We've been working towards this for decades, and now the time has finally come. ESO's Very Large Telescope, high up on Cerro Paranal in the Chilean Atacama Desert, is host to a spectacle unlike any other. For the first time ever, all four of its giant telescopes are firing powerful lasers into the sky. All in the name of science, of course. Optical telescopes have come a long way since the time of Kepler and Galileo. When ESO first started its journey building and operating ground-based telescopes in the 1960s and 70s, these already had main mirror diameters in the 1 to 4 meter range, specialized instrumentation, and access to some of the clearest skies on Earth. But in the 1980s, ESO had an even bigger ambition: to build the largest, most powerful optical telescope the world had ever seen. And what's more, this very large telescope wouldn't just be one single telescope. Instead, it would consist of four unit telescopes, each with a main mirror diameter of 8 meters. These so-called UTs could be used individually or combined into one huge unified telescope, the Very Large Telescope Interferometer, or VLTI for short. The big perk of interferometry is that it makes use of the wave characteristic of light to yield images sharper than would be possible with a single telescope. It's commonly used at longer wavelengths, such as the radio or the millimeter. An example of an interferometer that we've talked about quite a bit on this channel is ALMA, in which ESO is a partner. However, interferometry becomes more difficult the shorter the wavelength. At the infrared wavelengths the VLTI operates at, extremely complex processes are required to make it work. If you'd like to know more about this, please let us know in the comments and we'll dedicate an entire episode to it. Optical and infrared interferometry is so challenging, in fact, that the VLTI is one of only a few optical interferometers in the whole world. When it saw first light in 2001, it was possible to combine only two of the unit telescopes, and it took nearly a decade for all four of them to be linked together. Today, the VLTI can combine the light from all four unit telescopes, or it can use four of the smaller auxiliary telescopes. These are smaller telescopes with a main mirror diameter of 1.8 meters that can be moved around and were added to the observatory for more flexibility. The result is a huge virtual telescope that gives images as sharp as a telescope with a diameter of 130 meters when using the unit telescopes, and a diameter of a staggering 200 meters when using the auxiliary telescopes. At near-infrared wavelengths, that would be good enough to see me on the moon. Well, in theory. Ground-based telescopes have one major adversary: Earth's atmosphere. It constantly shifts, swirls, and distorts the incoming light, making it extremely hard to observe faint, distant objects. To get around this, we use a method called adaptive optics, a technique where we measure the atmospheric turbulence in the line of sight using either a real star or an artificial one created with a laser. We then correct for the turbulence using deformable mirrors. If you want to know more about how adaptive optics works, check out this video we made. For the VLTI, adaptive optics is crucial. In order for the light from the individual telescopes to be combined, it first needs to enter a tiny fiber, which is only about as wide as a human hair. If the light's too blurry due to atmospheric turbulence, this simply won't work. Up until now, the VLTI has been operating with a basic adaptive optics system and entirely relies on bright, natural reference stars. But in order to live up to its full potential, it needs something more sophisticated. And this is where the new lasers come in. They are part of the Gravity Plus upgrade, which enhances the existing VLTI instrument Gravity. Gravity was designed to, among other things, probe the galactic center and the region around Sag A star, the supermassive black hole lurking there. But Gravity Plus is more than just another instrument upgrade. It transforms the VLTI's infrastructure itself, gradually implementing an extreme adaptive optics system into the interferometer. And now it finally brings a laser to each of the UTs. By equipping all four telescopes with laser guide stars, the VLTI no longer depends on bright reference stars to correct for atmospheric turbulence. So essentially, this upgrade opens up the whole southern sky to the VLTI, allowing us to observe many more objects in much greater detail than before. Just like its predecessor, Gravity Plus will peer deep into the central regions of the Milky Way. But it will go further, uncovering even fainter objects orbiting around the supermassive black hole Sag A star. These will allow astronomers to better understand the black hole and measure its spin. But it won't stop there. Gravity Plus will extend our view of the universe to include galaxies and their black holes billions of light years away. It will also unveil hidden worlds, allowing us to peek into the atmospheres of exoplanets and search for signs of life. Gravity Plus and its lasers will open a whole new window to the vast volume of space, unlocking the full potential of the VLTI, just like astronomers and engineers dreamed of over 40 years ago.